أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له هاديا مرشدا ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير ونشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة فاللهم اجزه عنا أفضل الجزاء يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أحسن الكلام كلام الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله ومراقبته في السر والعلن فإنه سبحانه رأس الأمر كله. All thanks are due to Allah. We seek His help. We seek refuge in Him from our sins and the evil of our own selves. Whoever Allah guides is the guided indeed. Whoever led himself astray would have no guidance except from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The best words are those of Allah. The best guidance is that conveyed by Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. The worst of issues are innovations in this deen, for these open the door to misguidance and the doors to hellfire. I remind myself and all of you to be aware of Allah in all our states. Brothers and sisters, we are living the last few days of the most blessed days of the year, during the most blessed month of the year, the month of Ramadan. One that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam informed us of as awwaluhu rahmah وأوسطه مغفرة وآخره عتق من النار. Amongst the first third of which is mercy. The middle third is forgiveness, and the last third is saving from the hellfire. Our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never asked Allah to prolong his life except to reach Ramadan. He used to start prostrating in Rajab. Allahumma ballighna Ramadan. Oh Allah, make us reach Ramadan. Only out of knowledge of the sum of blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put in this month specifically for this ummah. Now that with Allah's grace and favor we have reached Ramadan of this year, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our deeds of this Ramadan in this world and in the hereafter. While living these blessed days, days of fasting, days of recitation of the Holy Quran and understanding its meanings and the message that great book comes with, days of praying and nights of Qiyamul Layl, days and nights of dua and days of barakah insha'Allah. Ayyaman ma'dudat, only a few days, as Allah says in Surah Al-Baqarah, and indeed they have been a few and they have flown by. We are closing on the end of Ramadan not knowing who amongst us would be here for the next Ramadan, or who would not, who would be lucky enough to see another Ramadan, or whose journey would end before reaching another of these blessings. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us reach multiple Ramadans to come in his obedience and worship insha'Allah. The companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam used to spend the 6 months following Ramadan asking Allah to accept their deeds of Ramadan, and the other 6 months of the year asking Allah to be able to make it to the next Ramadan. At the conclusion of the blessed month of Ramadan, the month of intense worship and gaining of closeness to Allah, we need to ask ourselves, where are we? Where do we stand? And where are we going? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teaches us that there are three kinds of nafs or soul or self. The first kind is an-nafsul ammara bis-su', the self that prompts one to evil. Allah says in Surah Yusuf at the tongue of the wife of Aziz, وَمَا أُبْرِئُ نَفْسِي إِنَّ النَّفْسَ لَأَمَّارَةٌ بِالسُّوءِ إِلَّا مَا رَحِمَ رَبِّي إِنَّ رَبِّي غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. I do not seek to acquit myself, for surely oneself prompts one to evil, except him to whom my Lord may show mercy. Verily, my Lord is ever forgiving, most merciful. The second kind of nafs that Allah teaches us is an-nafsul lawwama, the blaming self, reproaching soul. Allah says in Surah Al-Qiyamah, وَلَا أُقْسِمُ بِالنَّفْسِ اللَّوَّامَةِ, and nay, I swear by the self-reproaching soul. And the third kind of nafs is an-nafsul mutma'inna, the serene, tranquil soul. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Fajr, يَا أَيَّتُهَا النَّفْسُ الْمُطْمَئِنَّةِ ارْجِعِي إِلَىٰ رَبِّكِ رَاضِيَةً مَرْضِيَّةً فَادْخُلِي فِي عِبَادِي وَادْخُلِي جَنَّتِي. O serene soul, return to your Lord well pleased with your blissful destination, well pleasing to your Lord. So enter among my righteous servants and enter my paradise. The main purpose of the month of Ramadan, brothers and sisters, has been to achieve taqwa, awareness of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. The main purpose has been to get closer to Allah. to promote the purity of our souls, to achieve suppression of النفس الأمارة بالسوء, the self that prompts one to evil, and to promote النفس المطمئنة in every one of us. The question is, have we achieved our goals? Have we made use of controlling our desires for a whole month to promote our souls and ourselves to the more obedient, more serene souls that we are meant to have? More importantly, what are we going to do next so that we could keep this beautiful feeling of serenity for the rest of the year? What should we do to keep the momentum of being in a beautiful state of closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we have been achieving during this blessed month, and especially during the last few nights? I'd like to remind myself and all of you that our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam teaches us, من أتبع رمضان بست من شوال فكأنما صام الدهر. Whoever follows Ramadan by fasting 6 days of Shawwal, it's as if he has fasted the whole year. Moreover, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to fast the middle 3 days of each lunar month, as well as Monday and Thursday of every week. Doing that would certainly keep us on the right track, both physically and spiritually. Ramadan has been the month of patience, the patience that has two kinds. The first is being patient following the injunctions that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decreed for us. These are the fara'id. And the second kind of patience is patience constraining ourselves from doing things that our nafs incline us to do, but are against the injunctions of Allah. وَهِيَ patience عَنِ الْمَعَاصِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah An-Naba, وَأَمَّا مَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ وَنَهَى النَّفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَى فَإِنَّ الْجَنَّةَ هِيَ الْمَأْوَى. But he who feared to stand before his Lord and restrained himself from evil desires, most surely his abode shall be paradise. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Shams says, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ زَكَّاهَا وَقَدْ خَابَ مَنْ دَسَّاهَا. He who purifies it, meaning his soul, his nafs, will prosper. And he who suppresses it will be ruined. One of the wisdoms of the month of Ramadan has been abstaining from food and drink. The most beloved thing to a human being is food and drink. If we could control that, which we love the most, for the sake of Allah, it will be much easier to control other inclinations. That's how the wisdom of fasting works. عن عبد الله بن عمر أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال الصيام والقرآن يشفعان للعبد. يقول الصيام رب إني منعته الطعام والشراب بالنهار فشفعني فيه. ويقول القرآن رب منعته النوم بالليل فشفعني فيه فيشفعان. Narrated by Sahih Ahmad, At-Tabarani, and Al-Hakim. Abdullah ibn Amr, may Allah be pleased with him, narrated that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, fasting and the Quran will intercede on behalf of the slave. Fasting will say, O my Lord, I prevented him from eating and drinking during the day, so allow me to intercede on his behalf. And the Quran will say, O my Lord, I prevented him from sleeping during the night, so allow me to intercede on his behalf. Then their intercession is accepted. Have we tried to recite the whole Quran at least one time during this Ramadan, brothers and sisters? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam teaches us that whoever reads a letter in the book of Allah would be rewarded by hasana, multiplied by 10. And particularly in the month of Ramadan, this would be multiplied 70 times more. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stated, I do not say alif lam meem is a letter. I say alif is a letter, lam is a letter, and meem is a letter. That's how special Quran recitation during the month of Quran, the month of Ramadan, is. I remind myself and every one of you to try our best in the last few days of Ramadan to finish the Quran at least once. We should try to keep the momentum and maintain the habit of reciting the Quran on a daily basis for the rest of the year, what we call al-word. Choose the best time that suits your schedule, an hour before Fajr or an hour before we go to bed. Waking up an hour early or sleeping half an hour late wouldn't kill us, but it will keep us in touch with the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most beautiful message that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent to humanity. An Abdullah ibn Amr, anna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qal, yuqalu li sahib al-Qur'an iqra wartaqi warattil kama kunta turattilu fi ad-dunya فإن منزلك عند آخر آية تقرأها. رواه الترمذي وأبو داود وابن ماجه. عبد الله بن عمر, may Allah be pleased with him, narrated that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, it will be said to the companion of the Quran, may Allah make us from them, read, elevate, and recite as you used to recite in the dunya, for your station would be at the last ayah that you recite. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Jum'ah, هُوَ الَّذِي بَعَثَ فِي الْأُمِّيِّينَ رَسُولًا مِّنْهُمْ يَتْلُو عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِهِ وَيُزَكِّيهِمْ وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةِ وَإِنْ كَانُوا مِنْ قَبْلُ لَفِي ضَلَالٍ مُّبِينٍ. It is he who has sent to the unlettered people a messenger from amongst themselves, one who rehearses to them his verses, purifies their lives, and imparts to them the book and the wisdom, although before that they were in utter error. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uses the word ba'atha, to send. It is the same word used for resurrection, which indicates that those who are in ignorance, lacking the message of Allah, are equal to the dead. They need resurrection from ignorance to the light of faith, the light of the path of Allah. The best tool for this revival is reciting the book of Allah. وَقَالَ الرَّسُولُ يَا رَبِّ إِنَّ قَوْمِ اتَّخَذُوا هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ مَهْجُورًا. In Surah Al-Furqan. And the messenger will say, my Lord, my own people had made this Quran an object that was deserted. Beware, brothers and sisters, of deserting the Quran. We desert the Quran when we do not recite it, when we do not study its meanings, when we do not apply it in our lives, when we do not use its rulings in this ummah. Deserting the Quran is when we do not use it to remedy the diseases of our hearts. So at the end of this blessed month, let's take a covenant on ourselves to read and study the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on a regular basis all year round. Are we keeping our heeds of kinship at the conclusion of this month of Ramadan, Silatul Arham? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam teaches us that one who keeps his kinship is one whom Allah loves to reward, especially during those special times of the year. So make sure to call and visit with your relatives at the end of this blessed month, so that all your good deeds will be raised to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when He is satisfied with you. One should also be very keen to surround oneself with a good company that encourages one to do good deeds, encourages one to keep prayers on time, encourages remembrance of Allah for the whole year, and a company that makes it easier for one to stay on track, as has been especially during the blessed month of Ramadan. We should remind ourselves of doing da'wah inviting people to the way of Allah during these blessed days. لَأَنْ يَهْدِيَنَّ اللَّهُ بِكَ رَجُلًا خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا وَمَا فِيهَا. It's better for you than the whole world and what it contains if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides one person at your hands. Remember dua, brothers and sisters, as we've been enjoying it during Ramadan to extend it to the rest of the year. وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ فَلْيَسْتَجِيبُوا لِي وَلْيُؤْمِنُوا بِي لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْشُدُونَ. Let's keep our hands raised, asking Allah's blessings and forgiveness for the rest of the year. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. استغفر الله. الحمد لله والصلاة على رسول الله ومن والاه. Brothers and sisters, at the end of Ramadan, I'd like to remind all that the reward of fasting will not be raised to heaven until you give Zakatul Fitr, the charity of Fitr. The purpose of Zakatul Fitr is to bring happiness and satisfaction to the poor, the indigent, and the destitute on the day of Eid, so that they wouldn't need to beg on that day. For recognizing the need of the poor is one of the main goals of this blessed month. كان صلى الله عليه وسلم أجود من الريح المرسلة وكان صلى الله عليه وسلم أجود ما يكون في رمضان. The Prophet, peace be upon him, was known to be very generous, and he was known to be most generous during the month of Ramadan. Let's use this blessed month to exercise the generosity exemplified by the Prophet, peace be upon him. Brothers and sisters, let's take advantage of these blessed days by extending them to the rest of the year. Those days of longing and nights of calling to Allah, as enjoyable as they have been, should be extended to the rest of the year. Let's study the Book of Allah on a daily basis. Let's reflect on the status of our hearts. As we use this blessed month to get closer to Allah, shouldn't we try hard enough to be close to Allah for the rest of the year, enjoy that serenity and beautiful feeling in our hearts? Let's look at our lives and check our priorities. Brothers and sisters, we deeply believe in the Day of Judgment as part of our creed, and this month is part of the preparation for that day. May Allah give us an extended blessing of Ramadan to the rest of the year, full of obedience, awareness, and closeness to Allah. An extended Ramadan full of learning about Him subhanahu wa ta'ala and His religion that He chose for us and favored us with. May Allah open our hearts and our generosity to remember the poor, the needy, and the destitute in our community and in our society. Remember, brothers and sisters, that in this institution we make sure that Zakatul Fitr reaches its deserving people in utmost confidentiality, with respect and dignity to our Muslim brothers and sisters, and on time before Eid Salah is called for. Brothers and sisters, this is a time of repentance. قل يا عبادي الذين أسرفوا على أنفسهم لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله إن الله يغفر الذنوب جميعا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. Tell them, O Prophet, my servants who have committed excesses against themselves, do not despair of Allah's mercy. Surely Allah forgives all sins. He's most forgiving, most merciful. This Ramadan has been a great month with a multitude of blessings in this center. We've been blessed by daily iftar gatherings, Taraweeh prayers, Khatm al-Quran, inshallah, on Monday, Qiyam al-Layl, Tahajjud and I'tikaf, Suhoor for the last 10 nights. And above all, the best news has been the warm support of this wonderful community to this center. This is all has been part of the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continue to bestow His blessings on us. However, as American Muslims, we have been saddened by multiple incidents of aggression and assaults against Muslims, which reflects the danger of a rising wave of Islamophobia. We as American Muslims need to be vigilant, especially in big gatherings like Eid celebration. We need to stand together in solidarity. We need to be aware of our ummah affairs, both inside and overseas. And we need to support Muslim organizations that look out for Muslim interests in America and defend Muslim rights. We need to at least do dua for our Muslim brothers and sisters overseas who are being persecuted, who are being discriminated against and killed in cold blood. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us all to the right path. Please be vigilant, enjoy your last days of Ramadan, and enjoy Eid celebration safely, insha'Allah. Allahumma innaka qulta wa qawluka al-haq. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد إني داع فأمنوا اللهم تقبل منا الصيام وتقبل منا القيام وتقبل منا الركوع والسجود واجعله خالصا لوجهك الكريم اللهم انزع منه الرياء اللهم اجعلنا في ظل رحمتك يوم لا ظل إلا ظلك اللهم اغفر لنا وارحمنا واعتق رقابنا من النار اللهم بلغنا ليلة القدر اللهم بلغنا ليلة القدر اللهم بلغنا ليلة القدر اللهم اجعلنا من عتقائك في هذا الشهر الكريم اللهم لا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا إلى النار مصيرنا اللهم أسكننا فسيح جناتك اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم انصر المستضعفين من المسلمين في مشارق الأرض ومغاربها يا رب العالمين اللهم انصر المسلمين في سوريا وانصر المسلمين في مصر وانصر المسلمين في فلسطين وانصر المسلمين في تونس وانصر المسلمين في ليبيا وانصر المسلمين في جميع بقاع الأرض يا رب العالمين اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين وارحم أمواتنا وأموات المسلمين اللهم احفظ أبناءنا وبناتنا واجعلهم من عبادك المتقين اللهم ردنا إلى دينك ردا جميلا من غير محنة ولا عذاب اللهم أعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك اللهم اسقنا من يد حبيبنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم شربة هنيئة لا نظمأ بعدها أبدا اللهم احشرنا تحت لوائه وأسكننا معه الفردوس الأعلى ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون صدق الله العظيم.
Assalamu alaikum, brothers and sisters. I wanted to share the good news with you. Our fundraiser last Friday night raised $205,100. Jazakallah khair for all those who support us. And this last few days of Ramadan, if you have made a pledge,